Hey everyone, and welcome back to Celeb Trending. Everyone yearns for true everlasting love, but most people who can't find it just give up and settle for less or stay single. They say it is better to marry the one who loves you rather than the one you love. But true love does exist, and it is attainable for those who dare to challenge fate and write their own love stories. Steph and Ayesha Curry have proven time and time again that they are the ultimate couple's goals. The NBA player and his future wife met as teenagers through a church youth group. Eventually, they got married and were catapulted into the spotlight as Curry was drafted into the NBA. In the midst of a growing family, a huge public profile, and everything else that comes with raising a family in the public eye, the Currys have upheld their vows to the fullest, supporting each other's passions and holding strong to their faith. In honor of the couple's 9th wedding anniversary, here's a look at their beautiful love story. Stephen and Ayesha Curry met when they were teenagers at their church youth group in Charlotte, North Carolina. Steph's family moved back to Charlotte, North Carolina in 2002 after his father, Dell, retired from the NBA. That's when Steph would meet Ayesha Alexander, a fellow member of the youth group at the Central Church. But it wasn't love at first sight for the basketball star and the budding culinary guru. "We were just kids," Ayesha tells People exclusively in this week's issue on Newsstands Friday. "He was the cute boy at church that all the girls were obsessed with, so I made a generalization that maybe he wasn't for me. I don't remember the exact first day I saw her," Steph adds, joking. "There was no wind blowing in her face with a backlight." Ayesha moved on from secondary school early, and at 17 years of age, moved to Los Angeles to seek after an acting profession. By then, Steph had begun to become famous in the ball world, having quite recently driven his Davidson Wildcats to the NCAA competition's Elite Eight. Years later, when she was acting and modeling in Los Angeles and he was playing college basketball for Davidson, the pair reconnected when he was in town for the ESPYs. When he got an occasion to go to a ball camp in LA, he chose to look into Ayesha on Facebook for a get-together. She declined, however, left the entryway open for a gathering on the off chance that he was ever in the territory again. The next week, while around again for the ESPY grants, he attempted his luck. This time, she concurred, and the two spent their first date drinking chai tea lattes and hitting up Hollywood places of interest, like the Walk of Fame and Kodak Theater. In any case, the goodnight kiss was the place where Steph's luck ran out. "He was mid-discussion and came flying at my face without anyone noticing," Ayesha disclosed to Parents Magazine. "So I resembled no. At that point, I figured, gracious, I didn't have a clue about this is what was going on. I didn't know what the ESPYs were," Ayesha laughs, claiming she wasn't into sports before meeting Steph. "My parents found this paper from my high school theater class where you had to write down what you wanted in a significant other," she recalls. "At the bottom it said, 'No athletes because they're arrogant.'" Having just come off leading his team to the Elite Eight in the 2008 March Madness tournament, Steph was already starting to make a name for himself in the sports world. A fact that was lost on Ayesha. "She really didn't know what I did at the time," he says. "It was pretty refreshing." On the same date night, Steph spent all the money in his pocket to impress her by buying her a pair of Oakley sunglasses. Ayesha quickly realized preconceived notions about him were wrong. "He was so funny and silly," she says, "the absolute opposite of what I thought he was going to be." Not long after that, Ayesha felt some rejection of her own. "I told him I loved him first, and he said, 'I feel like I love you too, but I don't want to say it until I'm sure, because I want to make sure when I say it, I really mean it,'" she says. "I had to get in my car and drive home. I was crying." A few moments later, while they were with both of their families over Christmas, he finally says it back. "We were watching a movie, and he turned into my ear and said, 'I love you,'" she recalls. "Mind you, my parents were sitting right there. His parents were sitting right there. Our siblings were sitting right there. I was trying to sit and watch the movie, but I was freaking out. It was so special because I knew he meant it." The two had been dating for a couple of years when Stefan started to plan the proposal. On that day, Ayesha was planning to have a housewarming party at her new apartment in Charlotte. "We were going to his sister's volleyball game and then come back here. He showed up dressed really nice with a fresh haircut and cool sunglasses. I was like, 'Wow, look at you,'" she says. After the game, they stopped at Stefan's parents' house to grab the board game Pokano. As they were walking up the driveway, Stefan stopped. "He asked me if I knew where we were standing. It was the spot we had had our first kiss," she says. "He pulled me close and started saying all these sweet things and then dropped down on one knee. I was in a state of shock. She looked at the ring and asked if it was real. Stefan laughs. The next thing I knew, people were screaming from inside the house. All of our family was inside waiting. It was awesome. Steph and Ayesha tied the knot on July 30th, 2011. Both Ayesha and Steph wanted a traditional wedding in the church in which they grew up, and they needed a venue to hold the 420 family and friends on the guest list. Through the help of their wedding planner, Tiffany Radliff, at weddings in the city, they found their venue. Tiffany and Ayesha's mom helped the couple find Kristen Vining Photography. She captures something special, Ayesha says. The bride wore a strapless taffeta amsola gown with a custom-made veil, and the groom was decked out in a smoke gray tuxedo. When the doors to the church opened, Stefan was overwhelmed at the sight of his bride. Our pastor told me to look at him if I started tearing up, but he was already way past my tear level, Stefan says. That was the best part of the ceremony, though. I still have that picture of her in my head. It was a very emotional day for both. Ayesha was so overcome that she had to use her father for support. Just before the newlyweds celebrated their first anniversary, Ayesha gave birth to their first child, a daughter named Riley, on July 19th, 2012. Ayesha described her as a borderline honeymoon baby. In January, the couple announced in an Instagram post that they were expecting their second child. Steph wrote, "I didn't think it was possible, but my WCW just got even sexier. Baby 2 on the way. Been blessed beyond belief already, and I praise him daily. God is great." The doting dad continued to gush when Ryan Carson Curry made her debut on July 12, 2015. The couple welcomed their third baby, Cannon W. Jack Curry. Ayesha captured a poignant moment between the three siblings with the caption, "My heart is full. God has been too good to us. Our beautiful baby boy, Cameron W. Jack Curry, has joined us earlier than we thought, and we couldn't be more excited and grateful. Family of five." Steph had Ayesha's back as she showed off her culinary skills at her pop-up restaurant International Smoke at Chef Michael Mina's Test Kitchen in San Francisco. Even Drake stopped by to show some love to his fellow Canadian. Ayesha continued her hot streak that year as she released her cookbook, The Season Life: Food, Family, Faith, and the Joy of Eating Well, filled with the recipes she often prepares for her own family. He also paid homage to his wife as he received the first unanimous MVP award in the NBA history. "None of this is possible without you," he said. "You've given me the opportunity to go out there and work as hard as I do, spend the hours I need to do at the gym, during practice, in games, on the road, all while holding down the house and doing the little things that keeps our family going." In another interview, Steph told ABC News, "I am blessed with a wife that's willing to travel with me. I don't know what I'd do if she wasn't able to be there with me to go to different events. I mean, I have a 2-month-old daughter and she's been on 10 flights already. It's a lot to manage and we are still learning as young parents. Ayesha has basically created a brand for herself in the kitchen. We travel as a pack, our little wolf pack," she said, adding that when she's filming her food demonstrations or writing her blog, there's most likely a baby hanging off me or Riley is sitting at my feet playing with Legos. Plus, Steph is the most hands-on father. He manages his life and his day with so much humility. I'm just lucky to have him as my husband. The strong bond they've maintained over the years is evident, and it's often caused fans to put their family life on a pedestal, something they don't necessarily advocate. I don't like people looking at someone else's image, Steph says. We want to represent the right things because that's who we are, but we don't like it when other people say hashtag relationship goals and stuff. I just want people to understand they have to live their own lives the way they want to and not just what we do. For Ayesha, what matters most is being a positive role model for her children. What I want to represent for my daughters is that you can always stay true to yourself and still be successful, she says. You can have your cake and eat it too and follow your passions, have a family, and be happy. Let us know your thoughts on Steph and Ayesha's love story in the comments. If you like our content, don't forget to like the video, and please be sure to subscribe to our channel.